I came to Puebla at the invitation of RIMISP for the conference on for this international conference on territorial inequality and development, which in essence proposes a different approach to rural development, which is to take development from a territorial approach, namely from a regional standpoint, and to deal with the totality of the dimensions of development and growth and poverty and inclusion in a particular territorial dimension, which could be a locality, which could be a community, which could be a municipality, which could be a state. At the limit, it can be a nation, if you like, but we are dealing here really with sort of subunits of administration within particular countries, and asking whether we can redefine rural development from a territorial perspective, which means that it cuts across sectors. It's no longer agriculture or industry or services or tourism. It's all the sectors integrated together. It pays a lot of attention to heterogeneity. Different regions, different territories have different endowments, they have different histories, they have different institutions, they have a different capacity to organize economic growth, to provide jobs, to relate to markets, etc. So the three big dimensions to territorial development, as it has been discussed here, are number one, what we call endogenous growth, which is how do you organize and promote economic growth at the local level, meaning using land or using education or using different assets that the locality can have, and questioning what are the comparative advantages that it has and how can it engineer a process of economic growth which are going to create jobs. At the same time, the type of growth which is being sought is what we call inclusive growth, namely a growth which is as much as possible pro-poor, creating employment opportunities for kind of modest people, unemployed people, or poor people, so that we have at the same time economic growth, which is happening, but also poverty reduction. And hopefully, if you incorporate especially relatively poorer people, more equality. So you achieve at the same time income growth, poverty reduction, and inequality reduction, if possible, all of this in a perspective of sustainability, namely with a preoccupation with the use of natural resources and organizing the way of the use of resources in such a way that it is sustainable over time. So local economic growth, very important. Migration, in the sense that many regions have more population than they can productively absorb. And so people eventually have to, some people of their own choice and will have to migrate. But to migrate, you have to be prepared to migrate. You have to be informed as to where to go. You have to have the right skills and education that you can compete in the local labor market. The reason to go to the local governance issue, to the territorial, is that there is the belief that there are opportunities which are not being seized by what is being done at the national level. The national level tends to treat the regions in a similar fashion without maybe sufficient recognition of the individuality and the special advantages and opportunities and constraints that particular territories have. Right? So as a consequence, you don't optimize what can be obtained from each territory unless you recognize the individuality of each of those and recognize the need for local governance and the what local governance could do in a sense to make a better use of local resources. Right? So there's an efficiency purpose in going towards local governance, but there's also very importantly an equity issue, because many inhabitants of those regions will not move elsewhere, right? So you face situations of poverty and discrimination and kind of ethnic relationships, and they have to be solved locally. They are not, you cannot expect people to leave the region to find another future somewhere else in the country, because they are attached to this particular region. This is where their ancestors live. This is where the assets that they have are located. So you need to bring development to those regions. And it can be, again, done via transfers, which is sort of the, you know, the easiest way of solving the problem. But in the long term, it does not solve anything, because you need a sort of sustained transfer, which becomes very costly and can also create all kinds of bad habits and dependencies. So what's important is to create not only transfers and immediate relief, if that's the case, but to create opportunities for people to get jobs, to people to generate income. And one of the very important dimensions of the discussions here is the issue of inclusion, that unless you include people, especially with jobs that are meaningful, that give them expectations of a better future compared to today, people will be frustrated, especially young people. And you cannot have sustainable development models if you have high rates of unemployment among the youth, right? And yet, all too often, we have focused on aggregate economic growth, maybe based on resources like petroleum or exports, without giving due consideration to incorporation, creating opportunities for young people to be part of the process. Right? So that's what we call inclusive territorial development, which is a territorial development which is going to meet expectations of the youth so that they join, in a sense, creatively this process of local development instead of joining the rebellion or falling into gang warfare or even worse, if you want, all kinds of forms of violence that we see today. So, in a sense, we see that moving up towards sort of geopolitics and global governance to face up to issues, for example, of global climate change or migration refugee crisis, right, really should start at the local level. And that's the reason why we work on territorial development, which should aggregate, in a sense, into bringing a solution and relief to those global problems that we face today.